Hey guys, welcome back to channel Chalk and Dust. In this video I am going to discuss about the looks block that we have discussed earlier. So whatever the commands were left, we will discuss those blocks in this video. If you are enjoying learning this Scratch tutorial, please do subscribe it with your friends, with your peers, and please do like and comment your valuable suggestions. So here in this video we are going to start with this motion block. I'll just quickly give you a quick brief of the commands that we have discussed already. Like the say command enables a speech bubble either for a specific amount of time or maybe permanently. Similarly, the think bubble enables a think speech bubble or maybe the imaginary think speech bubble, maybe for the specific amount of time or permanently. Similarly, the show and hide block enables us to show or hide the sprite on the stage at any point of time, whereas the switch costume is to change between the costume of the sprite. So depending upon whatever costumes the sprite have, we can change any one of them by selecting it from the drop down list. And next costume allows us to switch between the given costumes automatically of its own. It will keep on switching to the next costume whatever appears next. Then we have to discuss from this switch backdrop too. So if I'll choose this switch backdrop too, I'll find this drop down list. If I'll click on it, I'll find these two backdrops enabled right now. So first is backdrop 1 and first the other one is castle 3, which is enabled just now. So if I'll choose this backdrop 1 here, click on this block, I can see that the block has changed to backdrop 1. Whereas again, if I'll click on this and choose this castle 3 and click on this, I will find that castle 3 backdrop enabled on this stage backdrop. So that's how we can switch between the backdrops of the stage area. So this may help you while you are creating any story type of animation. You can find various stage backdrops at certain point of time of the story. We can put those various backdrops one by one there and we can switch between them as and when required. Then coming next is to change color effect. So if I'll remove it and use this change color, so I'll click over here in the drop down list, I can find these various effects over here. Now whatever effect I will choose accordingly, I can put a value for them also. Like I have clicked over here and you can find the color has been changed to green for this sprite. So similarly, if I'll change its value maybe to 0 and click on it, it will go back to remain to the same. And if I'll change again it to 100, let's say I'll change it to another color. So it allows me to put any value between minus 100 to 100. I can change these values in between and I can put and I can find the different colors of this sprite. Similarly, set color allows me to set a default color at the time of initial stage of the program. So if I want to set any color permanently at the initial stage of the program, I can choose that color or maybe the effect, and then I can change, I can put it as an initial value. Like for example, if I just wanted to keep it pixelated, I'll select that pixelate effect and I'll use that maybe 10%, and I'll click on it. I can see that a sprite got pixelated for 10%. So that's how I can apply these effects and the values by putting these values. This change color and set color, the only difference is that change is something wherein I'm trying to change the value for these effects, whereas the set color, if I'll talk, so this set one is to initialize these values at the initial stage of the program. Now if I'll go for the next one, the second one is clear graphic effects. So clear graphic effects is to whatever graphic effects we have applied, be it any effect or maybe the color, I can remove them at any point of time if I want. So I can put it or use it in between somewhere in the program wherever required, and I can clear those graphic effects also. So if I'll click on this, I'll find that my sprite is again now to its default position. Now the next one is change size by. So I can change the size of this sprite also during runtime. So same as we have this grow and shrink button over here on the top, I can use these buttons to increase or decrease the size of this sprite before the program execution to set it at some initial value or maybe the size. But if I want to change some size maybe during the program execution, I can use this change size by also. So if I'll choose this maybe like a 10%, I'll click on it, it will change its size by 10% to its actual size. So like this, you can see it grow by 10%. Now if I'll put it as again minus 10, it will go back to its initial size. If I'll change it to 50%, it will become 150% of the actual size in all. Now if I go for 75% or maybe it in a negative value, it will reduce the size to its half here. So that's how this change size effects works. Then again, set size to is something wherein if I want to set any size initially for this sprite, I can put that as well. If I choose 100%, set size to 100%, I will find it at 100% of its size. So whatever size I want, I can be, it could be a negative value or it could be a positive value. So actually it has been just gone that reduced size that it is not visible. If I put it as 100% again, I click it, I can see it. So we can change or set the initial size. Again, next is go to front. So same as in many of the application, we can find that there are option to bring something into front or maybe sending to the backwards. So that we can do as well here in this Scratch also using these block of go to front and go back as well. So for this I require some more sprites. I'll click on this choose sprite library and I'll bring two more sprites. Let me one more bring it, let me this balloon. Okay, so here comes, we have three different sprites now. So we know that we can use or add multiple sprites now, right? So like here we have three. If I'll put them into a sequence, let's say this ball, let me increase its size a bit. So if I'll increase its size to this kind of a size, now we have three different sprites: a basketball, a cat and a balloon. Now if I'll put them into an order, so like the balloon, the basketball is the very last, then the second layer is this cat and the top layer is this balloon. So now we have three different sprites. So if I'll go back to sprite this cat and I'll bring, click on go to front, I'll see that this came into front of the balloon. Now if I'll click here, go back one layer, so I'll find that my cat went behind the balloon. Now if I'll click back again to this go to front, it will come in front. And now if this time I will use this go back two layers, that means I am trying to put it two layers behind. So the first layer is this cat, the second layer is the balloon, the third layer is that basketball. So it will go two layers behind, that means the balloon and the basketball as well. If I'll click on it, I'll find that a sprite is hidden now. Why? Because of it went behind the basketball and it is hidden now. So that's how I can change it or maybe bring it in front or maybe send it backwards as well. The last is three option or the checkboxes wherein I can put or see the values of these three costumes, backdrop name and size values here on the left top of the stage. So if I'll check these boxes, I can find this sprite costume number, the backdrop name and the size of this sprite. So this is all about looks block. So now we have completed and completely covered this looks block in this video. And the upcoming video we'll discuss about this sound block, which you already have seen a demo in my previous video of that nursery rhymes. थैंक यू गाइस, प्लीज़ कीप सपोर्टिंग योर ओन चैनल चॉक एंड डस्टर. सब्सक्राइब इट इफ यू हैव नॉट सब्सक्राइब इट टिल नाउ. प्लीज़ शेयर एंड लाइक दिस वीडियो. थैंक यू. हैव अ ग्रेट डे अहेड.